Welcome to the Spirit of Life channel. This message begin right now. The call welcome. Welcome. My beautiful beings of light, here we are together again to share the Creator's infinite love for you. Close your eyes and breathe deeply as the Creator's love wash surrounds you with the highest waves of energy that your beautiful essence can enjoy. Feel the essence of home as this energy integrates within your beingness. Just allow the emotions to flow. If you feel tears, know that they are tears of joy of remembering from whence you came. If you feel sad, know that you may experience this wonderful energy at any time simply by visualizing the highest essence entering your body. If you feel anger through this experience, there are things that need clearing and reconciling. Peace be with you all, my beloveds, that is the star that is to be followed. Peace within your own being. Peace with your children, families, friends, and co-workers. Peace within all that you do or attempt to do. Peace within your thoughts moment by moment, and compassion and kindness within each action. Peace within all that is. If you cannot find peace within your essence, then who will? So you see, this is a very tall goal. Returning to peace means that it must be in everything. Peace cannot be achieved through just a little focus. It must be inclusive and in all things, as well as practiced by all throughout all moments. Having said that, what do you think your role in this peace initiative might be? Have you even considered that it must be interdispersed throughout all your thoughts? It comes back to, what does peace look like, does it not? For those that have never seen or experienced peace, how would you describe this to them so that they might change the way in which their mind has been programmed for eons of time? How would you describe peace to a grieving mother that has lost all of her children to war, anger, and hatred? This precious mother that has never had a moment that was not permeated with anything other than fear? How would you draw a picture of peace to show someone how it looks? How would you tell a tiny child from a different culture than yours to cherish peace if they have never been exposed to what that meant? This is such a huge mission, my beautiful beings of light. You each came here to bring peace to earth within these moments of now. You each volunteered to be the way showers, the leaders, of peace. You stood in the longest of lines to incarnate into this realm within this time to clear the debris of decades upon decades and eons of third dimensional sludge, so that the shining star of peace, the white dove, would once again integrate its brilliance into this beautiful blue ball called Gaia. The energies of peace are begging to be allowed to reinvigorate this plane of existence. The white peace dove's time has come. This is the moment that you step across the line and show your commitment to your mission of peace. If not now, then when? If not you, then who? It will require bold moves of courage to model peace, for although you might have some inkling of what peace is, it has not been within you or without since your time of pre-incarnation, my beloveds. Can your convictions of peace withstand others' opinions? Can you stand firm and tall when others are making fun of you for your mission of peace? What about when others don't like you because your focus of peace makes you stand out as different? Can you hold your ground in the light when everyone else has selected other things as more important than bringing in peace? When looking at this mission through those eyes, how are you measuring up, my beloveds? Can you withstand the ridicule? No one ever said this mission was going to be easy. It was said, however, that this mission was rewarding. It was said that this mission was for those dedicated to the highest of evolutionary growth. You see, my beautiful beings of grace, to hold a vigil for peace with millions participating is wonderful, but when all is said and done and the vigil brought to a close, peace must be the focal point within the hearts and within all levels, dimensions, and aspects of each participant for that vigil's efforts to have any lasting residual effect upon the mass consciousness body. It is valiant for those that desire to gather for the sacred hope of peace, but it is another to allow peace truly to immerse itself within one's vessel. You are being called to remember the task at hand, muster your courage and be about your work. The moments are now. Here is a meditation to assist you with this effort. With your permission, this messenger will accompany you on this journey. Find a quiet spot where you will not be disturbed for a while. You may either sit or lie down, whichever is more comfortable for you. Cover your physical self with a light blanket if you chill easily. You want no distractions during your meditations, so always make sure the physical vessel is comfortable. Invite in at this moment all that you would have join you on this adventure. In your imagination, ask through prayer for the Creator to send you down a protective ray of white light by saying, "My Creator, I ask for a protective ray of white light to enfold me and lift me up so that I may experience the very highest of vibrations during this journey into my most inner depths of understanding and being. I am protecting myself from anything that is not for my highest good on this journey. I thank you, my Creator, for assisting me by sending this ray that is now coming down through the corner of the area where I am meditating. It is entering into this physical form, permeating all that is within this beingness's presence. The Creator has gifted you with an iridescent white ray plus a golden iridescent ray tinged with platinum for this journey. These are entering into your body through the soles of your feet and moving up through your physical vessel, permeating throughout all of your energy fields into all corners of the area that you are in, then exiting through your crown chakra. The rays are returning to the Creator and cycling back down through you again and back to the Creator in a circular motion. You are forming a figure eight with your breathing. The top loop of the eight goes over your head and the bottom loop goes under your feet. The middle of the eight is your waistline. It is forming the sign of infinity and it rhythmically continuing over and over again with each in-breathe and out-breathe. You are now divinely protected and nothing can even communicate with you that is not for your highest good without your permission at this moment. If it helps you to visualize by identifying your ego with a symbol or object, please do so. Direct your ego self to perch on your left shoulder. Instruct your ego self that it is to only be an observer on this journey. Breathe in deeply, my divine light beings, and feel the lighter, relaxed feelings of being divinely guided into this meditation. Breathe in deeply and know that you are breathing to the pulse of the Creator. Listen to the Creator's heartbeat and feel the love that courses through you each time you think about this moment. Breathe in deeply, allowing and seeing within your imagination your guardian angels join you and take your etheric hand to guide you into your spiritual heart chakra. Your guardian angels, spirit guides and special invited guests are now within your spiritual heart chakra, and as you locate and turn the doorknob of the golden door that says to my highest guidance within, you cross over the threshold. You find yourself in a white marble corridor. You see a phone on the table next to the elevator doors. As you notice it, the phone begins to ring. Your angels tell you to answer the phone. As you do, you are transported immediately to a crystal clear lake. There is a jeweled sign right next to you that reads, "Peace Lake, immerse yourself in these waters for instant peace." A bathhouse is right next to the sign. The angels point to the door and tell you to change into your swimming suit that has been laid out in the bathhouse awaiting your arrival at Peace Lake. As you change clothes, all types of thoughts are running through your mind about what this experience will bring. You exit the bathhouse and there stands your angels with large baskets in hand. They ask you to place into the baskets all current worries, concerns, fears, doubts. They tell you that you can pick these back up afterwards if you are so inclined, but for the moment they want you clear and focused on this one point of peace. You do as suggested, and as you place each issue into the basket, you realize how much lighter you are feeling. By the time you have placed everything in the basket, you are floating in the air. You begin laughing. Not only is this fun, but it allows you to experience joy as well. Your angels are joyous with delight as you allow the mirth of the moment to fill your empty vacant spaces. They tell you that this joy has now filled all spaces you emptied into the baskets. They explain that when you clear something, whether permanently or temporarily, as this might be, you then must bring in something positive to fill the cleared space. If nothing is intently brought in, then this leaves these spaces open to lower negative inhabitants of fear, etc. Nodding, you float on over to the lake edge. Your body just seems to make a soft landing into the lake. The water feels so wonderfully refreshing. You notice that there is something coming off of your body, kind of like an oil slick. The angels tell you that this is all the unpeace-like attributes, aspects, etc. being purged from your body. They are leaving because in this lake there is only room for peace. The lake will transmute all this and requalify the energy into peace. The angels continue to explain that as each non-peace part exits, peace is entering in its space. When you are finished with your swim in this wonderful lake, there will be peace integrated throughout your whole essence. You smile and like that idea. You continue to swim and splash and really enjoy this wonderful peace-filled water. You notice that all the debris shedding seems to have been completed. Your angels confirm this point. You are told it is now time to return. You sorrowfully come out of the water, and as you reach the shore, your body once again begins to float up in the air. You notice that there is not one water drop left on you as you float upward. You are completely dry, as if you were never wet. You float on over to the bathhouse and go back in to change back into your clothes. The angels have reprocessed your clothes so that any negative energy that might have remained in them prior to your dip in the lake will have been removed before you put them back on. They feel fresh and clear, what a luxury. You float back out of the bathhouse. The angels are there holding the baskets where you deposited all your concerns, troubles, and the like before you went swimming. They ask if you would like to have them returned. You take a moment and check all through your essence and notice that there is no need to have them returned to this now pure essence. You tell them no. As you watch the angels with one tap of their angel fingers transmute the issues in the baskets. You see this bright burst of light as these energies are requalified back into clear positive energy essence ready to be utilized for positive purposes. You feel so good and so light without all that inner turmoil. Your angels ask if you are now ready to return. You say yes. They snap their fingers and you find yourself back in the white marble corridor. Your angels open the golden door that leads back into your spiritual heart chakra. You pass through it and find that your angels are guiding you back to your physical vessel. Your angels help you back into your body. Your angels tell you that when you are ready, wiggle your fingers and your toes, open your eyes, and you are now ready to go about your day. Smile and know that this is going to be an outstanding day. My beautiful beings of light, you each are here to make your contributions. They may be large or small, but it requires all the pieces to the puzzle to complete the whole. Embrace your journey into peace and return to model this wonderful gift to all you encounter. Remember always that you are loved more than any earth plane language can describe. Be at peace and embrace the remembrance of who you truly are. The earth is changed one person at a time. Choose the miracles and release the grievances. I am Archangel Michael, the Creator's messenger of love, joy, wisdom, light, peace, and grace.